Did you know that 90% of the information processed by the brain is visual? Human brain takes 13 milliseconds to process an image. That's 60,000 times faster than processing text. People also retain 80% of what they see, compared with 20% of what they read, and only 10% of what they hear. No wonder then that data visualization tools are in high demand. Visuals provide us with an effective way to get our point across, especially nowadays when we're dealing with more data than ever. And not all visuals are created equally though. Some help you uncover dangers or opportunities that you never even knew to look for. I'll cover my favorite Power BI visuals I wish Excel had. You're gonna see how easy it is to turn your data into actionable decisions. Number one is the ribbon chart. This is great for viewing data over time and also keeping track of rank changes. It's right here. Let's add it to our report. Now we get an idea of how it's going to look, but let's bring it to life. We're going to add total quantity to the y-axis, and let's add an element of time to the x-axis. So here I just have 3 months of data in this model. I'll just add in the months. Now I get something that looks like a column chart. The ribbon is going to form when I add a category to the legend. So I want to take a look at the different article categories and how these developed over time. Let's add that to the legend. And now our ribbon comes to life. The way this works is that the highest range is always displayed on top. We can see our columns in the background. We have now stacked columns because we have different categories. So if I hover over this, we can see the total quantity for business, for casual clothing, party, and so on. And the beauty is the lighter areas in between. This is where we get to see the rank changes. Just like in the music charts where you get to see the change in rank, it's a similar concept here. And all of this is built in. So our business clothing here dropped 2 ranks. It was number 1 in February, it became number 3 in March. And this one right here, that's our casual clothing. It went up 1 rank to 1st place. Now the ribbon chart can be a bit difficult to read, so we can make some adjustments here to make it easier. First of all, on the x-axis, we can turn off the title. Let's turn on the data labels, and let's also activate this zoom slider. Here, if you want to get a closer look at January for that bottom category, we can zoom in and we see, oh yeah, this is our sleep category and we sold 500 items. Now this can get quickly overcrowded if you have many different categories. So it could make sense to add a filter to the visual and just restrict it to your top categories. So for a filter type, we would go with top N. We're going to base this on total quantity. And we just say, let's take a look at the top 3 categories. Number 2 is the decomposition tree. This is an AI visual and it lets you visualize data across multiple dimensions. You're going to find it right here. Let's add that in. We get to pick what field we want to analyze. I'm going to go with profit. Now we can decide what we want to explain this by. One field can be our article category, another customer gender, and perhaps customer city. Now we get the plus show up here. We can choose how we want to split our data. When I select this, I have the option between the different fields that I've added and also this part with high value and low value. Notice the light bulb here. That's the AI feature. This might help you uncover issues that you didn't even know to look for. So let's say I'm going to go with low value. The AI is going to get to work and decide what category it should show me. It picked city, Garland. We have negative profit here. Where is it coming from? Let's dig deeper. Low value, just from our sleep category. And if we go again to gender, it's from other or any. Now, once we've picked what we want to see, we can apply that same pattern to different values here. So for example, for LA, if I just click here, it's going to find the low value. So it picked other NA for gender, and it's coming from the casual clothing category. To see the different categories for female, I just have to make a selection here, and I can see party is where we have the lowest profit. Now, whenever you want, you can start the process again and look for something else. So you could decide to look for high value. This time the AI picked the gender category. Now you also don't have to use the AI feature. You could go and slice and dice as you want. So we're going to go with gender. Let's drill down for male by category. And notice here the party category is making negative profit. And if I want to see where it's coming from, I'm going to drill into city. It's coming from Seattle. If you want to lock a field in place, you can. So notice when you hover over these, you get the lock icon. So if you always want to have your first drill down to be gender, you can lock it in place and then leave the rest flexible. Okay, so this is a great visual for getting information about your data that you didn't even know to look for. Next up is the scatter chart. I know Excel has one, but it's not as cool as Power BI's. Check this out. We're going to add the scatter chart. Let's bring over the sales value to the x-axis, profit to the y-axis. Total quantity is going to go for the size of the legend. Okay, I just have one bubble now, but we're going to split this by customer state. So I'm going to add state as the legend. Now I can see my different bubbles here. So this one is California. It's all the way up here. Now, what makes this so different to Excel? Well, it's this part, the play axis. We can add a time factor here. So I have my dates right here. In this case, I just have 3 months of data. So I'm going to grab the month and drop it in the play axis. This is also difficult to read with the legend up here. So let's go and quickly format this visual, turn off the legend, turn on the category labels, and let's also make them bigger. Okay, so California is all the way up here in March, but was it always like this? Well, let's play this. We see January, February, and March. If you have data for longer time periods, you are going to be able to just play this and understand the change over time. And last, we have infographics and custom visuals. You see, the great thing about Power BI is that you aren't even restricted to what you see here. You can go and grab more visuals. From here, you get to search for what you want. I'm going to go and grab the infographic designer. Let's add it in. It was successfully imported, and I can see it on the bottom here. Each custom visual has its own settings, but let me show you something cool you can do with this one. Let's add it in, add in gender and total quantity. I'm going to change up my measure to show values as percent of grand total. Okay, so now let's go to formatting options and see what we have. We just get chart. We can pick between different types. I'm going to stick to column. We can turn off the X, Y axis. But where can we add our shapes? Well, not here. We can add it in right here. Okay, let me just expand this so we can see the options better. I'll bring it up. And we get specific designer options. This is where we can add in the different shapes that we want. If you want each column to have a different shape, which in this case I want, we're going to go to data binding off and select our data binding field. This is gender. Now we can select a different shape for each of these. When I select this, I can pick different shapes from here. Under people, there's a female one. Let's go with that. Male, there's one right here. Other NA. I don't find what I want here. No problem, we can upload our own SVG file. I happen to have one here. Let's select that and add it in. Now we can apply this and we see these update. But I want them to have the same height. So I'm going to go to layout, adjust this setting to be outer. Okay, so things are looking better. We want to add our filling based on the percentage. So fill percentage is going to be based on percentage of total quantity. But notice female is fully filled in. I don't want that, so we're going to add a maximum value of 1. And now the filling is updated accordingly. Now you have more options, so you can adjust the color if you want. I'm going to turn this on and go with a light yellow color. You can also add the actual percentage to this. So we can go and add text. I want the text to be dynamic. It should be a data label based on percentage of total quantity. Let's apply that, go back and adjust the formatting. Let's make it really big, make it bold, and add it to the bottom. Okay, so that looks good. Let's make this smaller. Now, the great thing about this is that it works similar to other Power BI visuals. You can cross-highlight and cross-filter. Let's say we had a bar chart in place that was showing our profit for the different categories. When I select the different categories, my visual is automatically cross-highlighted. I hope this brief introduction to some cool Power BI visuals inspired you to be creative when you design your reports and also to experiment a little bit. It just takes 2 minutes, maximum, I guess, to add a new chart and tweak it a bit to see what it's capable of. If you have a favorite Power BI visual, let me know what it is in the comments below. Before you leave, like, subscribe, and I'm going to see you in the next video.